The story of computerization began in 1979 when the MNHN professor assembly decided to buy a computer. Very important thing in this period. So, 1 year later, the MNHN bought a Mini 6 computer with very big memories and two hard disks. And this computer was installed in the oceanographic laboratory in Rue Cuvier. And the main objective of this computer was to give access to researchers to the center interregional, le centre interrégional de calcul électronique. And in 1983, the main machine decided that this computer can also be used to manage all the national collections. And they decided to use the Fish collection as a prototype of this computerization. So, 3 years later, they bought a new computer because they realized that the computerization of the collection increased a lot the memories. And they also decided to develop a network, the first network in the museum. And they connect 8 laboratories all together. And they bought 15 consoles to give access to this computer from the different laboratory. They also fixed 2 new objectives to this computer: the connection to the European Academic and Research Network, and they start also to use this computer to help the administration for management purposes. At the beginning of the collection, the database collection, the first discussion started in 1975 with Professor Daget and Jean-Claude Duro, and they start to think about how to computerize the collection. And in 1983, the MNHN start to test the first database and develop its own software to manage the collection. This software was to allow several users to connect at the same time and for different purposes to the database. That was incredible. As you can see on this figure presented in 1980, present the GSIM database. In 1986, the database already contains 30,000 records, and in 1987, 55 data are entered. The estimation at this time was 80,000 lots for 1 million specimens. In 1996, the database moved to a new computer and used a new software. Since this period, we can observe the annual evolution of computerization, and now we have reached 130,000 records. This is much more than the initial estimation. We are now reaching a plateau after a big effort to computerize all the collection. The process to computerize the collection was to check the card stored in the lab of the Fish collection, compare this card to the label on the jar and, of the registration book. All this data was written on paper, on data entry form. And in a second step, another team computerized all the data from this form to the database. At the beginning, we used a software developed by Jean-François Muraille, and after this, he developed a second software called Jasim, since used actually with different versions. This computerization of the collection was the reason of the first contact between Rainer Freuse, Daniel Poli, and Jean-Claude Duro. In 1991, they were agreed to exchange data from GSIM to FishBase. And the first agreement will be signed between FishBase and ICLARM to do this work all together. At this period also, the MNHN starts to experiment the web and proposed the GC database online as one of the first fish collection in the world. In 1996, the first collaboration between FishBase and the MNHN gave us the possibility to cross-check the taxonomic table from FishBase, catalog of fishes, and GSIM, and to check geographical occurrence data, and to transfer all this data from GSIM to FishBase for the occurrences and collection tables in FishBase. At this time, in 1999, FishBase contained 60,000 records from GSIM, and that will be very useful to get the georeferenced data. And in 2001, the MNHN becomes a member of the new FishBase consortium. At this period, FishBase was used to provide the GSIM data to the GDIF. Since 2002, GSIM provides this data directly to the web and to GDIF and other databases such as OBIS and FishNet. And now FishBase gets the GSIM occurrences from the GDIF and not anymore directly from the MNHN. When I speak about the occurrences data, we start this the data from the collection from the GSIM from the museum start in 1970 to 1975, 1950. On the oldest specimen, there was only 5 specimens from French Guiana, and they was collected by Monsieur Ratier, and from Atlantic Sea, collected by Andorcio. In the second period, the collection gets 130 more specimens, mainly collected by Geoffroy Saint-Hilaire during the Egyptian expedition of Bonaparte, and from the collection of Commerson in Réunion Island and Mauritius. The expand the fish collection really started to grow with important expeditions all over the world, such as the Bodin expedition, the Uriani voyage, or the Astrolabe expedition with Dumont d'Urville. We get during this period more than 3,000 specimens from everywhere in the world. You can find this history in the text speech book about collection building on an article from Madame Beauchamp in 1990 about explorator. At the beginning of the 80s, we get 8,000 more specimens from everywhere, from Talisman and Travailleur expedition. At the beginning of the 20s, the collection comes from everywhere, but not from a special big campaign, mainly for different collectors who go everywhere. But we cannot Dolphus, was on board the Pourquoi Pas with Charcot, Baudon, or Théodore Monod, who start to bring many specimens to the collection. During the last decade of the 20th century, we observe a large expansion of the fish collection with almost 63,000 specimens, mainly collected during the Caribbean cruise, the campaign Muserstorm, actually known as the planet revisité in the Pacific, and campaign from Tucker around Kerguelen Island. Voilà. The collection continued to grow with 20,000 specimens more this last period. Mainly from Salomon Island, from some campaign from Pacific Island, and from Muserstorm, planet revisité. On this slide, you can see the taxonomic name, the taxonomic presence, the taxa present in the collection. And actually, we have almost 15,000 taxa for 136,000 records. And we have almost 13,000 type specimens. Most of the collection, 65% of the collection come from marine fish, and other from freshwater. When we check the database, we can also see the identification work done during the collection. And it's very important to give a good quality data and to be able to provide a good data. As you can see, the identification work has been done mainly since 1990. And the main contributor to the identification is on this graph. On this slide, you can see also, we can see the use done with the collection and the number of loans since 30 years now. And we send more than 6,000 specimens all over the year. And we answer to almost 5,000 requests. So it's 60,000 specimens that have been requested. One of the contributions to FishBase is to provide pictures, images from the collection. And since 2020, we have almost 16,000 images, including pictures on X-ray. This has been funded by the National Science Foundation for two different projects. And this last years, with the project Reconnect, give us the possibility to obtain all the images from type specimen. The pictures are presented in the Mediatek or directly in the collection, and we provide all these pictures to FishBase, and you can find them on the pictures pages. Since 2004, we also start to computerize all the osteological fish collection. This collection includes collection of otoliths, osteology, scale collection, and it comes from the main fish collection and also from the anatomy comparée. We also provide a website for exploration of osteology called Osteobase, and this website is a link to FishBase, and you can find also the information in the pictures FishBase information. If we, the last thing that we provide with GSIM, it's many specimens are linked to a citation. We have almost 5,000 references computerized in GSIM, and we tried in 2013 to develop a website called SpeNews. This work was done with FishBase teams, and particularly with Emily Capulli, and I thank her for that. And this website tried to automatically analyze publications citing a national number to identify the specimen cited on this. So this website can link the collection on FishBase directly. I want to thank all the people that all over this year, these 30 years, work on the computerization. So it's a person from the MNHN and also main a lot of computer contracts. Thank you.